Hey guys, this is Pat Cox. Welcome back to round one of Theros Draft here on Channel Fireball. We are going to mulligan to six cards. That hand's not very good. This hand is also not very good. It has two six drops in it. This is a cantrip. Fortunately, only have one lands. Guess we're going to mulligan to five. Alright, well, that is better than the other hands. I guess I'm glad I played 18 lands. Looking at my opening hands now, I feel very ridiculous with all these six drops. I think it's actually fine, like as the deck's built and all that, with all the voyaging guys. But could have also taken the fourth one, I suppose. All right, well that's a good draw. Can play my courser on turn three if nothing else. Maybe draw a voyaging, satyr, satyr, something or other. Nice. Well, that's about as good as Last Breath can be. It's actually pretty huge right here. Destroyed a land for 2 mana. I can probably play something right now that outclasses this. Doesn't quite outclass it, but still not great for me. That's having a Savage Surge in hand right now is pretty great because I can attack with impunity. Guess he can give it pro green, but oh well. Yeah. Doesn't cost me anything to do that. If he suits this up, that's pretty bad for me. Like. Okay. Guess I trade. It's not getting any better for me right now. Can't attack. All right. Well, if we get our next couple land drops, we're not in the worst shape. It depends on what he does, but. Yeah, like if I can play this and then like sea gods the next turn. Ugh, all right. Well, probably pretty dead now. Maybe if I maybe still have hit the next two, maybe I'll be okay. Nah. Get to scry twice if it lands. Probably a way to remove this. We're gonna just do that. So I take 10. Okay. Block 99 creatures right now. Well, that's pretty good. I don't think it's good enough to win me the game, but it's pretty good. Boop, boop, boop. Don't need lands anymore, really. This guy's pretty good. Does any of this do anything for me right now? I don't think so. I can make this an 8, a 6-8. Eh, I lose one of my guys, whatever. I guess there could be some argument for keeping land, so I could like activate this every turn, but I don't think it necessarily makes sense. Alright. Now, I don't know if I want to pump things or gain life. Guess we're gonna have to play this by ear. Gain life says I'm pretty good. I'm just gonna untap target artifact with this. Jeez. Well, I guess getting this big enough this can trade with this would be pretty good. The next turn, if he mount, I needed to draw something. It's like a chump blocker, basically. Yeah. I guess it's probably right to put a plus one counter on this. Could gain 3 life that negates one of his attackers. It does that anyway, though, if I don't draw a guy. Alright. Well, it's not a bad draw. Actually activate bow too, thanks to my voyaging guy. Alright, I guess we can hang out for a minute. I don't know if we want to attack with this. Yeah, I don't know if he means like, cause it's like worth money or just it's lucky to draw it right there, but I guess both are probably true. Yeah, I don't really want to attack. I didn't even know it made foil tokens. That is actually pretty sweet. Oh man. Man, we are, we both got some sweet cards going on here. Alright. I'm probably gonna gain life right now. I don't know if that's better than. I'm just kinda worried about him. I don't know. Gotta do something with this bow, though. Pump this. Still pretty good to make the 100 hand of one bad. I don't know, if he makes three guys, I'm gonna gain life. Alright, well that is pretty good. I guess I'll attack with my guy. Probably attack with just one of these. It's like sneaking in there. Has death touch. Right? Yep, my guys have death touch, okay. Targeted the wrong land accidentally. It's unfortunate. It might have something to do with these lands, I have no idea. Are you gonna tap with this too? Alright. Whatever. I'm gonna put that on top. Blockers. Like this thing. Guess block one of these. Block this. I don't know if that's better than killing one of these other things. Let's see. So all my guys are dead. I care less about the Master of Waves. Actually, I don't really care about the Master of Waves at all. Whatever. So I take 5, go to 1. I don't know if these are like the total optimal blocks, but they seem somewhat reasonable. So, okay. So it's 2, 5, yeah. Kind of don't really want to use the bow unless you use the card in his hand. So I'd like to be able to gain life if he has another pump spell. By the way, this is what I was talking about. Trading tax is just pretty sweet. I mean, I don't know if it's necessarily obvious I have it there. Like, we are kind of stalemated, and he has to have a way to, like, make the three guys for it to actually screw me, but... I guess blocking, yeah, I probably should have been, I don't know, blocked in such a way that this was trading off anyway. I don't know how to do that, but it's like, this is going to die now either way. Could have, like, not blocked with this. I just gained the, I don't know. It's a pump spell, like, I do want to be able to live through it. If I, like, leave another guy unblocked, it's pretty bad for me. Also could have possibly taken the opportunity to kill the 100-handed one. One, two, three, four, five, six. I'm gonna go ahead and let's see. 1, 2, 3. I have to play in 5 mana next turn, so I can't activate this. So yeah, I'm gonna put a +1/+1 counter on this guy. So let's see, I can block 2 things, can't Mantras this yet anyway, can gain 3 life, go to 7, does it make sense to attack right now? Because I scry 3 if I attack, which is pretty good. So I'm going to block this here, this becomes a 6, but I can gain 3, go to 7, so I'd have to chump that if he draws a Planes. Eh, still probably worth it. Like, pretty big upside if he doesn't draw planes. Bottom, bottom, top. I've had fairly ridiculous draws to be in this game at all. Man, like, this has gone on a lot of turns that I thought I was just dead. Pretty lucky to top deck two lands to even get to the Sea Guy's Revenge slash this guy. Pretty lucky. So he has the Asp still in his hand. Okay. I don't really care about any of this, I don't think. I don't know, I guess this guy gaining life's pretty reasonable. Like, we're somewhat stalemated, but I get to gain 3 life a turn anyway. I don't know, I guess I do just want to draw action, so. Would I rather have this or the Dryad? I guess probably that. Yeah. Kind of greedy to put everything on the bottom. Like, I do want to draw a spell. How much does this cost right now? I don't even know. One. Two. Three. So, reduced by 3. Alright. So, I'm gonna do that. So, this is reduced by 3 again, so this is 6. So, I don't have enough mana to do that. Well, that guy's fine. Bottom. Bottom. Top. Okay. Okay. Got asps for days. Alright, so I'll cast this. Guess I want to pump this. I'm going to attack with both these guys. I'm going to pump it again. No, I actually can't pump it again. I have to pump it. Alright. It's going to take several turns of pumping for that to work. That's probably stupid. I guess I can trade this off. I don't really care that much. I get him for 3 damage anyway. That's fine, whatever. This is like one of those cards where it's like hard to use it too poorly. Attack my two unblockable guys, and he dies. Okay. Oh, he can monstrous this. Well, I should have pumped then. Damn it. Okay, well. Actually, what am I doing? I could have timed to fed on that. That's stupid. Yeah, could have like foxed on that. I mean, I don't know if there's anything that's gonna screw me right now or anything, but it's still pretty stupid. Well, that's annoying, but don't particularly care. I guess I also could have attacked with this because I have Death Touch and Trample. So overall, I'm playing this game great, is what I'm trying to tell you. Just fantastic. Yep, should have been dead last turn several ways. Like, even if I don't draw the time, Fee's dead. Jeez. Yeah. Pretty bad. Alright, well, I'm glad I won that game. I was pretty lucky to even do that, but I did not play very well. Also, he has multiple ass, which makes my flyers pretty bad, especially this guy. Because at least these guys can just attack into them, it doesn't matter all that much. Don't know what I want instead. This guy's okay against Asp, I guess. He also has a lot of expensive things. The Stymied Hopes is not the worst thing in the world. Eh.
Woo.